All right, so the X3, it's got this haptic feedback, which I like. The screen, which I really like. The screen's just big enough that I can see myself in the framing right now. And it's kind of already made for portrait. So I can see what my portrait framing looks like. So we're down here in Chester at the stadium. This is for overdose awareness. So I'm gonna give a ride and test the camera and check out the community. All right, here we go. They're having a dedicated record button. It is really nice. I probably would say it's probably one of the nicest things I like about it. Just having that dedicated button so I can engage it nice and easy, and I don't have to worry about which button I'm hitting. Seeing that screen is really nice. Hello. It's still recording. I can see it's still recording because I get the red light at the bottom. But the screen is recording. I mean, the camera's recording because I can see the red light. But the screen's off, which is kind of cool. We could take a look here. Here's a nice little group of people. And it's showing some support. I love this. I love this. Afternoon.
So during this test, I just took it out of the box. Hit the record button, all auto settings, no external microphones, and I think it did a really good job. So this is the Subaru Stadium in Chester.
I've actually been to a couple of the matches out here. Oh, look at this, there's like a little victory garden is what we used to call it. All right, now we're coming up on the main area. I'm gonna raise this up so we can get a better view.
Over 107,000 people have died from overdoses in the United States alone in 2021. So it's good to show support for things like this and let people know that they're not alone and that there is help out there. And hopefully we can save some people, future generations. This wall is pictures of people that have died from overdoses in Delaware County alone.
All right, so let's do a little ride down to the waterfront, 4K60.
Now in this test, I bumped up the record frame rate to 60 frames per second at 4K. And then I sped up the film a little bit just to give it a little bit of a punch and made a little bit more action. And it held together quite nice, I thought. One of the reasons I like using Insta360 cameras is you can just shoot and then I can go back and reframe, make the camera fly around, do different things, but tell the story a little bit better. And this invisible selfie stick, I'm actually holding the stick with the camera on the end. And as you can see, you don't even see the stick that's there. So I would say for any adventure, this X3 is just amazing. The screen allows me to look at it. I didn't have to pull out my phone once to link it up to look at it. I could just pull it out and go and just start recording. Really good for run and gun, good quality. The X3 will be my go-to these days. That does have some other functionality in it, but this video was really about take it out of the box and just go and see what you can do with it. See how I can use this as another tool in my toolbox. If you have any questions, please hit me up in the comments. Really do appreciate you watching this video and all the support, the comments, the subscribers. And till next adventure, remember, take care of each other, peace out, and I'll see you all soon.